that chapter, Numbers 23. This is the year 2023. Praise God. Numbers 23. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Will you then say amen? Okay, what person is there? Numbers 23. Right, are you all there? Numbers 23. And I will read to you from verse number 20. Verse number 20. Behold, behold, I have received a command to bless. I like that. I have received a command to bless. He has blessed and I cannot reverse it. You see, God has blessed no man and nothing on this earth can reverse it. Say amen to that. It's a command. When God has commanded his blessing, there's nothing, nothing, absolutely nothing that can reverse that blessing. He says, I have received a command to bless. He has blessed and I cannot reverse it. He has not observed iniquity in Jacob. Understand this. Jesus became a curse so that the blessing of Abraham might come upon the Gentiles. Come and talk to me, somebody. Amen. That's Galatians. Jesus endured the curse on our behalf. He took our place, so he took the curse, so that the blessing of Abraham might come upon us. That blessing has been commanded. Once a blessing has been commanded, you cannot bless it. You cannot reverse it. Amen. And because of Jesus, the price that Jesus paid, he bore our iniquity. I shared it with you on Christmas Day. He bore our iniquity. Amen. The chastisement of our peace was laid upon him, was poured upon him. Say amen to that. Hence now, when God looks at you, he sees you through the works of Christ on the cross. He sees you through Calvary's cross. He sees you through the blood. Remember, the blood removes sin as far as the east is from the west, so far as it removes our transgressions from us. How far is the east? How far is the west? I mean, you cannot measure it. So far as it removes our transgressions from us. Hence now, he says, he has not observed iniquity in Jacob. Nor has he seen wickedness in Israel. The Lord his God is with him. Come on, talk to me. The Lord your God is with you. You see the way it says he has not observed iniquity in Jacob. Put your name there. Come on, talk to me, somebody. He has not observed iniquity in Jacob. Nor has he seen wickedness in Wayne. The Lord, kindness, God, is with her. Come and talk to me. You've got to personalize this. This word is real. Talk to me, somebody. The Lord is God is with me. Oh, I love this. And the shout of a king is among them. I'm here to tell you this morning, in your family, in your home, it doesn't matter what you've been seeing, it doesn't matter what you've been hearing, it doesn't matter what you've been feeling, I'm here to tell you that there's a shout of a king in your worship. Amen. Hallelujah! Amen. There's a shout of a king. God brings them out of Egypt. God brings them out of Egypt. He has spread like a wild ox. You understand? God has brought you out of 2022. 2022 for you would have been a year of captivity. Because Egypt is symbolic of captivity. 2022 would have been a captivity, a year of captivity for you. Where there were things that you desired to do, but you could not do them because there were limitations. It would have been a year of limitations. Talk to me, somebody. There could have been some setbacks in 2022. It could have been a year of setback for you. It could have been a year of struggle. There are things that you probably struggled to get through. There are things that you desire to God never left you. You know, sometimes you cry, oh Lord, everybody's left me. That woman that was caught in the act of adultery, did she cry to Jesus and say, oh Lord, where's everybody? No. Jesus asked her, yeah, those who accuse you. Now you're accused. Sometimes people leave you because they've been accusing you all the time. They couldn't recognize the gift of God in you. You see why it was a struggle? You were trying to row your boat forward, but while you're rowing your boat, then you're digging holes so you're not getting to where you want to be. And you must remember, God is the pruner. God is the pruner. He prunes. Why do you prune? You know, when I came out of hospital last year, I told the doctor one thing on my hospital bed. And he asked me, Mr. Flynn, what are you thinking of? I said, I see myself in my garden. And the first thing I done when I started to walk in my yard, I asked the boys, where's the pruning scissors? And I took the pruning scissors. And I went to the rose, all the rose bushes. I love roses, but lots of roses on them. So I went to all the rose bushes and I started pruning. I've never done it before. I started pruning. Do you know that all the ones which I pruned, because there were some I couldn't get to because of my health, my understanding, some challenge, you get to. But all those which I pruned started blooming. We've had more roses than ever because of pruning. Sometimes God will prune so that you can be more fruitful. God removes stumbling blocks. You see, a stumbling block is a wall which delays the process. And God has to remove that so that it can be easier for you to get to where God desires you to be. See, God pruned you because He wanted to get you to a place where you can realize and understand that He is all you need. God is all you need. Come on, son.
Amen.
You started 2022 with God. And when you ended 2022, guess what? God was there.
Yes.
And you entered into 2023. God is still here. Are you getting what I'm saying? The Bible says God brings them out of Egypt. God brings you out of 2022. Hallelujah. You see, let me tell you something about the difference between God and man. The difference between God and man. People will do things for you so that they can talk about what they did. That even if something were to happen, they'd tell everybody what they did. Not God. God will not tell you what you did. He'll tell you there's much more. If you think this is it, there's much more that happened. There's much more I have to do. You see, people do things for you to buy friends with you. To buy friends. God doesn't do things to buy friends. God does things because He loves you. He does it out of love. And because He loves you, He'll do much more. You know, when you read Romans 5, there's so many times Paul uses the word much more. Much So God says to you, 2023, I have much more in store for you. Come on, somebody. God says to you now, if you thought that was it, if you thought that was good, watch now. Watch the space.
Hallelujah.
God says in 2023, you are on your way out. You are riding on the king's highway. Because there's a shout of a king in your midst, and his name is Jesus. Come and talk to me, somebody. It says here, he has killed. God brings him. God brings him out of Egypt. God brought you out of 2022. And because he brought you out of 2022, you now have the strength of an ox.
Amen.
You have the strength of an ox. I just told you, you are being developed for 2023. In other words, you now, listen, you started, why 2022 was a difficult year, is because you started the year and you thought you'd do everything on your own. But you had to go through a process because God was, you were in training. You were busy gymming. You were busy exercising. All those things have made you stronger. Everything that happened to you has just made you stronger. Because in 2023, you have the strength of an ox, you have the strength of God. You have the strength of God. Hallelujah. You have the strength of God. 2022, you thought, you felt the times like throwing in the towel. You felt the times like just giving up. But hey, God says 2023, you make a comeback for that setback. Because now, I am your strength, I am your strength, I am your strength, I am your strength. Come talk to me, somebody. Hallelujah. You have God's strength. It's not my might nor my power, but by my spirit, says the Lord. And listen, you might, you know, you might have lost everything and you say, oh, you know, I don't care what you've lost. I don't care what has happened. I'm going to start over, but Lord, I'm starting from scratch. Let me tell you, get that word scratch out of your vocabulary, because you are not starting over by scratch. You are starting over with experience. You have experience. Experience is the greatest teacher. Experience has taught you to be wiser. Experience has taught you to be sharper. Experience has taught you to be smarter. Hallelujah. Better. He brought you out of unemployment to bring you into employment. He brought you out of But you know what? Many people have forgotten today. But Matthew 1:23, behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a child, and his name shall be called Emmanuel, which means God is with us. 2023, God is with you. God is with you. Say that with me, God is with you.
God is with you.
Watch that. The book of Exodus, to watch that. It's 2023, people. Exodus 23, verse 23. You see, it's numbers. I'm not normally a number person, but man, when I started praying and praying to all of this, God just started opening my eyes. And true, it was amazing. Exodus 23, verse 23. God says, for my angel will go before you and bring you into the Amorites and the Hittites and the Perizzites and the Canaanites and the Hivites and the Jebusites. And I will come to earth. See that? My angel will go before you and bring you into the Hittites. You see, you've got to get to the Perizzites and the Perizzites. The Hittites and the Hittites. The Canaanites. Canaan is a land of promise. God has given you Canaan. God has given you Canaan. God has given you promises. Canaanites are promise keepers. But God says, my angel shall go before you. And he'll bring you into all of them. You see, wherever you go, don't run away. Don't run away from the Canaanites because they need to see the promises of God manifest in your life. Don't run away. You see, many people, they're going to run away. Don't run away. Jesus said, let your light shine. Let it so shine. And then they see your works and put it by your Father. Where does light shine? Light can only shine in the dark. I mean, look at these lights here. Yes, there's light. But if you look outside, it'll be brighter. So the darker you get, the brighter you shine.
Yeah.
The Canaanites need also to come to realization that God is with you and that God is with them too. So they need to be saved. Talk to me, somebody.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Joshua 1. Joshua 1 verse 9. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and be of good courage. Do not be afraid nor be dismayed. For the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. When you go to work, God is with you. When you go to the supermarket, God is with you. When you go to school, God is with you. When you go wherever you go, God is with you. Say amen to that. The Lord is your shepherd. Faith is the evidence of things not seen. Come on. shall be done by my Father who is in heaven. He says to Philip, Philip, that will be with you so long yet you ask me, show us the Father? He says, the words, watch it, the words that I speak not by my own authority, but the Father in me does the works. 2023 shall be a year of agreement. Agreement. It will be a year of you agreeing with God. It's not a year where God agrees with you. Because when you want God to agree with you, you bring God to your heaven. It's a year where you agree with God. It's a year, come on, you're going to go to his end. James chapter 5, speaking of Elijah the prophet, he says, Elias was a man similar to us, and he prayed. And the heavens were shut by the space of 3 years. And he prayed again, and the heavens were opened. You see, Ezekiel 37 carries by those words. He answers God and says, God, 2023 will not be a year of, oh my Lord. It will be, yes, me, Lord, send me. It will be, yes, Lord, send me. Not, oh, why me, Lord. Yes, Lord, why not me? Why not? Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You will not cry in 2023. About why me. Instead, you will plead with God for why not me. In 2023, it will not be a year of I don't know. It will be a year of Lord, you know. Ezekiel said, Lord, you know. And what God said to Ezekiel, he said, prophesy! Speak what I speak! In other words, he said to Ezekiel, agree with me on what I have said. Agree. It's a powerful, most powerful agreement that can ever be made. It's an agreement made between a believer and God. You must remember, God is the triune God. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, they are one. Man is a triune God being. He's a spirit. He lives in a body and he has a soul. Get ready for your miracles in 2023. never ever again. The Holy Spirit will come, and the person upon whom he came will accomplish the purpose that God had called him to. And then the Holy Spirit will come. But now the Holy Spirit has come to abide. He's come to remain. Jesus said, if you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you will ask whatsoever you will, and it shall be done for you. You abide in me, is the word, is the spirit. And his words abide in you, you will ask. In other words, in 2023, you're going to say what God says. And when you say what God says, it's just as good as God said it himself. Just as good as God saying it himself. That's what it is all about. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You see, you need a year of God working in you and through you. I just shared with you about the Holy Spirit, how you come, how you go. Come when you go. Elijah goes to the king and says, for the next 3 years, there will be no rain in this entire land except when I speak with the king. He walked with God, he spoke God's word, and it was so. The book of Job says, thou shalt declare it, and it shall be established. Jesus says, you speak to this mountain, it will go. You're going to speak the word. You're going to say what God says. Before you say what God says, you're going to just see mountains of victory all around you. Every mountain that runs on the starting block, you see, wow, my word. Come and talk to me. I conquered. Wherever you look, you see mountains of victory. When two walk together, there's going to be a king. Agree with God. Because 2023 is the year of divine partnership. It's the year of divine partnership. I am partnering with God. It means I will do my part and God will do his part. I got to be somebody. God is just waiting on you to do your part. He's not even ready. You've got to do your part. You see, when you do what you're supposed to do, God will perfect it. God will perfect it. You will partner with God. If it's, listen, let me tell you, if you think this way is a worship team, when you start to do what God wants you to do, let me tell you, you might not be able to sing, but God will give you, come on, he's going to give you a skill. Listen, there's an outpouring like never ever before. I mean, previously the Holy Spirit would come and he would go, but now he's come to remain. And you know what, you've got to be where he wants you to be, when you are where he wants you. He will put his seed. He will perfect with your talents, with your gift, come up with your giftings. When you can start doing that, come and talk to me, God will perfect. When you can start speaking word, God will fulfill that word, because you're speaking what he's speaking. You're saying what God is saying, not what man is saying, not what the government is saying, not what the priest is saying, but what God says. That is that partnership means co-workers. You see, Paul understood this. That's why he said, we are co-laborers. Co-laborers, we work together. He knew we are working together with God. Every servant of God worked with God. They had God working with them. I'm here to tell you that 2023, God is working with you. Even financially, when you partner with God financially, your finances are going to come right. You may say, Pastor, I don't know where to start. Just start somewhere. You know, you can start gentle with the rest of the God. God was about to leave. The rest of God didn't have a question. You see what happened, the same thing happened. Even if you and I, in your prayer time, you know, when you experience God, and you experience that when you are having prayer, I mean, prayer is so important. You speak to your prayer. That after you pray, you know, you go about what you Father, thank you for the privilege of your people. Here of the fight partnership. Thank you that you are with us in 2020. Thank you for all that you have in store for us this year. Father, you created us for a purpose, for your purpose, for your plans, and they will succeed. Now, as I release your grace and water upon your people, I pray you will bless them. I pray you will keep them. Your hand. The Lord bless you, child of God. The Lord keep you in the palm of his hand. The Lord God of heaven and earth, cause his face to shine upon you, his precious child. Upon all the works of your hands, the Lord God of heaven, pour out from heaven the rivers of his grace and blessing upon you in the year 2023. The Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the Holy One of Israel, the Ancient of Days, cause the glory of his presence to be upon you in 2023, upon your house, upon your home, upon your workplace, upon your job, upon your business, upon your family, upon your heart, upon your life. The Lord give you the fullness of his shalom, peace, life, fullness, peace, all the blessings of his love, in the name above every name, in the name of Yeshua Jesus, the Messiah, the Anointed One, the light of this world, the lily of the valley, the rose of Sharon, the glory of Israel, and the lion of the tribe of Judah. In Jesus' name, amen, amen.
Now, we can go to that to the last one. Hallelujah. Giving is the most remarkable importance originating in the heart of the giving God. Hallelujah. A God who pours forth more blessings on his people than you can ever deserve or expect. Hallelujah. The gift of life, the gift of love, the gift of salvation, the gift of eternity in heaven, all these are priceless. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is more than we can do. There's nothing that we can do to deserve this. It's just the love of God. Because he loves us, he gives us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The possessions we have are generally a tangible result of what we have invested in time and in energy and in talent. But who we are, our character, is always a direct result of what we have invested ourselves, God, in others. Hallelujah. And one of the great and unique promises of the Bible is that the more we give, the more we receive. Not necessarily in material possessions, but in spiritual and eternal rewards as well. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is good. All the time. We rest from joy that for God so loved the world that he gave. As we begin this new year, let us have love and give. Let us have love and give. Let us share the love that God has given us. Here is the love of God that has brought us to this place this morning. It's the love of